Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Monday, the 20th of August, 2018. Wow, is it ever smoky around here? I mean, you've seen the videos of the smoky sun and the helicopter. Today's a little bit better. You can see the sun, like you can see shadow. We got a bit of it, like I can see the trees moving, like the lilac bush right there moving a bit. So a bit of a more of a, like yesterday was a very light breeze, just enough that you could feel it. But actually there's movement today. So hopefully that'll move the smoke out because it is just nuts. Phone call from one of my kids yesterday and the smoke goes all the way. It's all over. It's all over. My kids are 5 and 6 and 7 hours away from here and they're feeling the effects. So but a lot of smoke, I can feel it in my eyes. The helicopters were not flying yesterday. There were Kelowna flight cancellations, people weren't getting their flights, a lot of cancellations, local, you know, regional airports around here. I don't know how Vancouver was, I'm sure it wasn't. Last night I heard one plane fly over, like, but high altitude, like, you know, not anything low. So but yeah, the smoke, like, supposedly the military got deployed. I don't know what the deployment was about. I have no idea. I just heard about it. I know the wildfire crews, we have a whole bunch of guys in town here, they're working their asses off, you know, like big shifts, like everything is just so smoky. From what I gather, I was told I was at a barbecue last night and the smoke. I can taste it. I haven't been running. But I was at a barbecue and somebody was saying that Prince George, the air quality for Prince George is worse than some Chinese cities. Now, I've never been to China, so I don't know how bad the pollution is there, but supposedly Prince George was like number 3 or something. It was like China, Canada, you know. Temporary, but really bad. Like, people here in town with breathing problems are having issues, so, you know, it's pretty nasty. But everybody's working hard, everybody's doing their thing, and hopefully we're supposed to get some rain this weekend. It's cooler, you can see I'm in my jammies, my duvets out. Like, it's cold. Well, cold. It's coldish for what it's supposed to be normal in the summer, okay? It went down to about 10 degrees last night, 10 degrees centigrade, which I think is possibly 40-something degrees, so 40 Fahrenheit. Anyway, also sorry about all lack of videos, but like I said, when family's in, that takes priority, and with just busy, it was just a write-off of a week, pretty well back to normal here on Monday, so we'll start the vlogs up again, and the breakfast vlogs, the backyard vlogs, and hopefully the smoke clears, go for some hiking and that. It's supposed to be a hike up the Saddle Mountain coming up soon, so in about a week. So hopefully I'll get on that crew and we'll go up and hopefully the viz will be good. You know, because that's the whole idea, to go to Saddle Mountain is to get the big visibility and the scenic cast from way up there and everything. So, but what have I been doing? What was I doing lately? I don't know why I got on this topic or this thread, but I was looking at JFK. I was trying to think about, like, because I was thinking about all the distraction and everything that's being thrown at us now with, you know, the world, and everybody's looking over here when something's going on over here, and you see it now. It's very obviously. Now when I see anything that's really out of the ordinary, I'll look elsewhere immediately. Like, you know, something that just doesn't pass a smell test, I look elsewhere immediately. And then I was thinking about our history and, you know, about a lot of things that happening back when I was, you know, my first generation on the planet, or my first century, or my first decade on the planet, the 1960s, and what was all going on then. But there again, you know, that was 0 to 10, right? Roughly. So I was looking at the JFK and the moon stuff. I was doing both of those little thingy-ding-dings to try and, you know, so I went through a whole bunch of, and I didn't even realize it, the JFK thing is still going on big time, okay? Now, I don't know why. After pouring through everything that I poured through last night, I would say, let's say I spent, oh, I don't know. Out of the whole, all of it, JFK and the moon stuff, you know, all of the Apollo and 13 and all that stuff, about 3 hours. We'll just say about 3 hours. So, what did I take away from that? JFK was not shot, and this is my opinion, JFK was not shot by a lone gunman. After watching all the videos and reading a whole bunch of alleged eyewitness testimony and this and that and the other, I'm of the opinion that no, JFK was a coup, that's what happened there, so we'll just leave it at that. The moon landings, I'm of the opinion that it's part and parcel. There's real and fake. We did the whole gambit. Everything was done, and there's real and there's fake footage. So it's all mishmash of both. So I'm of the opinion that, yes, we've had probes sent to the moon. Yes, we've had lots of stuff that we've gone to the moon. We've done low Earth orbit. But we've never actually set foot on the moon. That's my opinion. Now, I'm of the opinion, you know, and people call me whacked out. I don't care. But what I poured through last night, there's enough anomalies to say that it's possible that we did not set foot on the moon, but I am of the opinion that, yes, we have been to the moon. I have not been to the moon with probes and other items to do our bidding. I'm of a mind that there is no... Look at what was going on in the 60s. Look at what was going on in the 60s. Look at what was being said. And I was listening to all the Russians and the Americans and everything that was going on. So you got to look about what was going on in the 60s. So that's my opinion. Yes, technologically, we have been to the moon. But I'm of the opinion that man has never set foot on the moon. But we have sent stuff there. I mean, you can send probes there. We did that. We did that first, if I'm not mistaken. And the Russians did that as well. So that goes without saying. I mean, you can send a piece of machinery anywhere. You know, that's not a big deal. Now, getting a human creature up there and back, that is a big deal. So, you know. Anyway, that's my opinion. Now... It's distraction has been something that's been going on forever, so I'm really surprised, you know, and my opinion can change, like my idea can change, but it really strikes me as odd when people just are vehement about it, and with all of what's been going on in our history and that what we've seen come to light in our most modern history with stuff that we've been lied about and manipulated into doing or whatever, what have you, it strikes me as odd that people are so rigid in their... thought processes that they just can't go there for whatever reason, you know. I'm not sitting here saying that, oh, the reason we didn't go there was because there was aliens already there and that they told us to go home and to never come back. I can't go there. That's a step that I can't take. But with all the stuff that I poured through the reading and the videos and everything, through Russia and America and what the space race and the Cold War and all that stuff tells me that there was some sort of grand deception going on. Okay? That's it. Same with JFK. Where we are today is part and parcel of where we came from and the journey that brought us here today. So I could be wrong, and I don't care that I'm wrong. It doesn't matter to me that I'm wrong. You thinking that I'm wrong is okay too. I mean, it doesn't matter. The stuff that's gone on in our most modern history tells me that, yes, it's possible that it was a distraction. In my opinion, we have not set foot on it. Yeah, we could go there and take pictures and do a soundstage and make everything look nice so that in case, you know, we might have tried to go. I don't know. But too many things, too many anomalies. And you know, and with that being said, there is so much out there now to discredit. You know, anything like if like if you try and debunk something, there's going to be somebody trying to debunk your debunking, right? Like the 9/11 NIST, you know, stuff like that, and you know, anyway, we can go on and on and on. I'm rambling. That's my opinion. That's my 2 cents. That's my breakfast vlog. I hope everybody's doing well. I hope it's not too smoky where you are. No, I can see the sun just a bit. Well, I mean, I can see the reflection. I can't see the sun right now. It's over there. But peace to you. Take care. Hope to see you on the flip side.